Hello, my name is Dave Tenney. I'm a product manager with Agilent Technologies. I'm going to demonstrate some new waveform generation software that works with several Agilent function generators, arbitrary waveform generators, and pulse generators. I'm going to begin with a simple walkthrough of showing you how to create a waveform, download it to the instrument, and then we'll show you the waveform on the oscilloscope. So let's begin by showing you what the software looks like when you first start it up. You first get the choice to create a new waveform, actually create a sequence of waveforms. You could open an existing waveform created by the software, or you could import a CSV file of a waveform from some other software that you're using as well on your bench. For right now, we're going to do this basic walkthrough. So I'm going to create a new waveform. Now the first thing we need to do is select the instrument that we want to connect to. This sets some defaults in terms of the number of arbitrary waveform points and the size of memory, things like that. So we're going to connect to a 33522A, which is the function arbitrary waveform generator that we're going to be demonstrating the waveform with. Then we have a choice now of setting up some waveform parameters. I'm going to just pick a 100 millisecond duration for this waveform. And let's select a sampling rate of 1 gigasample per second. And that will give us 100 kilosample points to work with as we create our waveform. So I hit OK. Now I'm going to get a display here that looks much like an oscilloscope where I can begin creating the waveform. But before I do that, let's just take a walk through the capabilities of the product, and then we'll begin by creating a simple waveform. So first under the waveform menu is where, basically where I do the creation of the waveform. So I have one section here that are basic waveform segments, much like the ones that are built into the function generator. I have some advanced segments that get a little more complicated, things like a multi-tone segment. I have a trapezoidal segment here. And in fact, you can even build a serial data segment. Another way to create some waveforms is through an equation editor. And then finally, there are some drawing modes, a freehand mode, a line draw mode, and a point draw mode. The point draw mode has interpolation methods that you can select, linear, smooth, which is like a polynomial. And in fact, there's an area here where I can reset my duration and sampling rate if I'd like to do that. So let's begin by just creating a very simple waveform. We'll select a sine wave, and I'm going to create several cycles of the sine wave, and then we'll download it to the instrument. You'll notice as I go through the demonstration, you will see this window quite often. It's basically the waveform creation window. Once it's open, I can actually change the waveform. For now, we'll just keep it a sine wave. And let's run it through the whole 100 millisecond time duration. The default amplitude is 2 volts peak to peak, and we'll just leave it there. But let's set it up to run for 10 cycles. You'll notice I get a preview window at the bottom of this window to see what the waveform is going to look like. So when I hit OK, now I get the waveform in the display. Let's do one more thing before we transfer this waveform to make it a little more interesting. Let's say that we want to take one cycle of the waveform and let's just have a drop out there where it drops out to DC. So I'm going to select a cycle. I'm going to pick a DC component. And this is, we're going to do this for 10 milliseconds. And we want the voltage to drop to zero, which is the default setting right now. So we select OK. Now in this case, since I already have a waveform on the screen, it's asking me where to put this new waveform. I'm going to basically say replace the selection and say OK. And now you'll see that I have a dropout in the sine wave here to a DC level. So let's download this now and look at it on the oscilloscope. So I go to the communications menu. The first thing I need to do is to actually connect to the instrument. So I have to find the instrument first. So the software has to find the instrument first, then I do the connection. So under Find Instrument, you can see now that it found the 33522A. I simply hit Connect. And now I'm connected. In fact, I have a USB connection right now to the 33522A signal generator. I can also connect with LAN. Okay, so now there's a default waveform name that comes up. You can rename it yourself, but we'll just leave the default. It's called Waveform 1. So now I'm just going to send it to the instrument, and we'll see it show up on the instrument as well as the oscilloscope. And you can see that we have that DC, that one cycle of zero DC that we edited into that 10-cycle waveform. That's the walkthrough of Agilent's Waveform Builder Pro signal generation software. We will be showing you some additional videos with creating more complex waveforms as well as creating some sequences of waveforms. So thank you for watching.